First, I saw several cases on social media, and I was very interested because this came from very good people and very good vascular interventionalists or surgeons. And I saw very nice results, lesions that looks very complex, that were fully opened after preparation. So I said, I want to try this. And that's how I tried the shockwave balloon for the first time. It's true that when you use this device for the first time, you do not know if it's the effect of the device that opened the lesion or just a simple balloon by itself that will open the lesion. So at first sight, you say, well, it's working, but you need more data. And doing cases and cases, you start to see that constantly you have nice result of the preparation. You also see on the angios and the fluoroscopy that the calcifications goes on the side of the lesion and stay there. So doing cases and cases, you feel more comfortable that the device really works and that it really allows better preparation. I would say that after 4 or 5 cases, looking at these lesions that were really fully opened after preparation by the shockwave, which is, I remember, a low pressure balloon. You use it at 4 atmosphere and you see this very calcified lesion opening fully with the pulses. Then you start to say, well, it's really working. For sure, the shockwave balloon is for heavily calcified lesions. And where do you find heavily calcified lesion in the peripheral arteries? For sure, in the lower limb, 2 main locations are the common femoral artery. These are very calcified lesions, high calcium load. Also, it's when you have this lesion at the P2 level, popliteal artery, where you see these lesions that are very calcified, a place where you don't want to put a stent there. You prepare the lesion with the intravascular lithotripsy, and that way you try to avoid the stent there. It's really a benefit for the patient. Here you can see the case of a 79-year-old male with a very disabling claudication on the left side and intermittent rest pain, failure of the rehabilitation program, and he has a very tight stenosis of the popliteal artery related to a heavily calcified lesion at the P2 level. Based on the preoperative CT scan, we take it to the angio suite and we do an angiogram where you see this lesion that is nearly an occlusion of the popliteal artery. After crossing, the lesion is prepared with a 6.5 shockwave balloon based on the preoperative sizing. And after a good preparation, then a DCB is used for 3 minutes to avoid restenosis. Here is the final angiogram showing a really nice result in this case, and the patient was discharged the same day. After 1 month, the patient is healthy. He has no more disabling claudication. The duplex scan show very nice result of the procedure with no more significant stenosis at this level. In my experience, there is no safety issue with intravascular lithotripsy. And also looking at the literature, there is no safety issue. You don't have this emboli that you can see with the atherectomy. You don't have this low flow phenomenon that are probably microemboli that you see also with atherectomy. You have less major dissections than all other preparation tools in these calcified lesions. So really I'm not worried about the safety with this device. When you use shockwave for the first time, try it on a heavily calcified and short lesion. For example, a short plug of the popliteal artery or the common femoral artery. These are probably excellent indications of intravascular lithotripsy.